Once called the Danish Michael Jackson, in 1982, Mike Tramp left his native Denmark for the promise of rock and roll glory in the U.S. By 1987, he transformed his band White Lion into a ferocious live act and landed a record deal with Atlantic.
I remember getting the first $1,200 check and going straight down to McDougal Street and blowing it within 2 minutes. It was three pair of boots, a leather jacket and pants, and now I'm playing rock and roll.
The band's album Pride sold more than 2 million copies and spawned the top 10 singles, Wait, Lion, Had a Ride.
I never looked back at all the money that I made and all the money that I spent. I felt it was kind of just monopoly money. Here's $10,000 for the show tonight. Well, what do? We were jumping around up there screaming, now we get free beer, and hanging with some chicks. And now you're gonna pay me for it? Well, I'll have some more, please.
By 1991, the ladies had lost interest, and the big check stopped coming. White Lion's brand of rock was replaced by a new sound.
Suddenly there's just two big steel doors getting closed in your face saying, hey, you're not happening anymore, dude. And therefore you go, well, what did I do wrong?
In 1991, White Lion broke up. So where is Mike Tramp now? Welcome to Lake Tahoe, Nevada, playground to former rock stars and current snowboarding enthusiasts.
You know, the second you get up on the mountain, you have to, you know, really concentrate, you know, on not killing yourself. Once in a while, you need to get out of your house, because I can be the kind of type of person that just would sit there and stare at the phone and just saying, well, ring, damn it, ring.
Mike's move to the mountains of Nevada came in 1994, when the singer could no longer tolerate the LA lifestyle.
In LA, nobody will tell each other the truth. Nobody will say, you know what? I'm really having a rough time, man. I'm broke. I'm depressed. They won't answer my phone calls. So go to a place where you could go up to the mountains and you can get some clear thinking.
Mike may enjoy life up in the mountains, but his daily life is grounded in reality.
I know when things are on sale. I watch my coupons.
Children cry. The singer has also been trying to jumpstart his career.
When the children sing.
In 1998, he released his first solo album, Capricorn. But Mike's past still haunts him.
When you hear somebody making fun of the 80s, it gets to you in the way that you weren't a comedian. We all were serious rock bands, even though the videos didn't look like that.
Mike has serious plans for the future. He continues to write more material for another solo album.
I have more to offer musically, and I'm not washed up on the beach. I'm not outdated. It's just really saying, hey, you know, I know I was part of the 80s, but hey, I didn't kill anyone. Give me a break. Listen to my music.